Hello everyone, I am Monica Bhushan and today we are going to start partial differential equation lecture number 4. So in today's class we are going to start formation of partial differential equation by eliminating arbitrary function. Okay, in last two class we have completed formation of PDE by eliminating arbitrary constant, and today we are going to start this method, which is by eliminating arbitrary function. So in coming classes we will be covering all different forms under this topic. Okay, so now what we are going to start with, so this is, there are four questions which we have taken today. So the very first question is z equals y square plus 2 function 1 by x plus log y. So this function actually has 1 by x plus log y. Okay, so in this method where we are forming the partial differential equation, we have to actually eliminate the arbitrary functions. Okay, that means which all things are allowed and which all things are not allowed, that first we will be discussing. So z is allowed, like how we used to allow z in my PDE when we used to form the PDE by eliminating arbitrary constant. Now even the independent variables, this y is independent variable, so this is also allowed. This is this function which we can denote with function or f or fn or phi, it all depends like how you will understand, because this is the function, correct? No, so this arbitrary function we will not keep in our answer. So this function notation here, this is denoted with function f, so this we don't have to allow. Okay, but this x is okay. So this x is my independent variable. So y is also okay. So we will be seeing that how I'm going to eliminate this function and we are allowing this x, y and all those things. Fine. And then we will be seeing all those questions. Okay, so very first question is written here and the step is exactly same what we used to follow in the previous method, right? So step one is what? I think you remember. So this is step one, is I have to check that whether this function, which is my z, okay, z depends on how many independent variables, right? So I can see two independent variable, one is y and one is x. So I'm going to find partial derivative of left hand side with respect to x, fine, and then partial derivative of right hand side with respect to x, fine. So this is I have written like this, that is okay, fine. Now what I'm going to do here, so del by del x of z is nothing but p, and then del by del x of y square plus del by del x of 2 into f 1 by x plus log y, fine. Now p equals del by del x of y square will give you how much? It is going to give you 0. The reason is same, because if you are going to partially differentiate with respect to x, so you are going to keep the other variable or all other variables as constant, and del by del x of constant will give you 0, fine. No, so plus 2 I have just taken outside, and this function is there, so I'm going to write down f dash, that you know that first derivative of f will give you f dash. So f dash 1 by x plus log y, okay, and then inside it, so this is what, x to the power minus 1 will give you how much? Minus x to the power minus 2, correct? No, and then del by del x of log y. So again the same thing, del by del x of log y is del by del x of a constant, that means plus 0, so I'm not going to write that one. So this is p equals 2, or I'll write down here how much, minus 2 by x square, because x square I'm just keeping in the denominator, and then this is f dash 1 by x plus log y. Okay, so we are done with this equation. Now we are going to find the partial derivative with respect to y of the same equation, okay? So del by del y of z will give you q, fine? And then right hand side is what? Del by del y of y square plus del by del y of 2f 1 by x plus log y, fine? No? So this is how much? So q equals del by del y of y square will give you 2 into y, and then del y by del y will be 1. So plus 2 I am taking outside. And the same thing, if you are finding first time derivative, so f will become f dash. So this is f dash 1 by x plus, this is not x, correct? No, this is y. So this is my y. So 2, so 2 is there, and then this is f dash 1 by x plus log y. So where I will find the difference if I am taking x or y, so afterwards, right? So if I am finding out del by del y of this complete thing, so for that, this 1 by x will be constant, correct? No, because with respect to y, if I am finding derivative, so I am going to treat x as constant, so it will be my 0, and then this is plus del by del y of log y will give you 1 by y, okay? So now finally I got q equals 2y plus 2, and then y I'm taking here, okay? And then f dash 1 by x plus log y, okay? So we can see here also p we also had got the same thing, and q we also had got the same thing. Okay, now what is next? So now we need to think that how many functions are given in this equation, okay? So I can see only one function. So this function is whatever is written here. So this is only one function present in the question. So I have to find only one order of partial derivative. That means only del by del x of z and del by del y of z and del by del y of z is enough. Okay, I don't have to go for second order. When I'll have to go for second order partial derivative? What is second order partial derivative? Del 2z by del x square, okay? Or del 2y by del y square. And if you are going to have the different del x, del y. So that is my second order partial derivative. But that will be needed if I will be having two functions given in my question. Okay, so here since only one function is given, so I'm going to do only del by del x of z and del by del y of z. So if only this much was my work, so how I'm going to get this partial differential equation? So with these two equations only, I have to somehow manage to eliminate this function. Only I am concentrating on eliminating the function, nothing else. Okay, all other things are allowed. So here, so p is there, q is there. So you can see that this is common, right? No, f dash 1 by x plus log y, f dash 1 by x plus log y is common. So I'll take the value of this function from my first equation and put it in the second equation, then I'll get the answer, correct? No. You just focus on this equation. This I can write p x square. X square I'm taking here, the left hand side. So p x square equals my minus also I'll take here. Minus p x square equals 2 f dash 1 by x plus log y. Okay. And what about my this equation? The second equation I'm going to write how? So this will be your q minus 2y, suppose q minus 2y, because 2y this part I have just taken in the left hand side. So q minus 2y is nothing but 2 f dash 1 by x plus log y, and then divided by y, okay? No, 1 by y. So now what I can do, y I'll take in the left hand side, so it will be my y if I'm taking again here. So q minus 2y equals 2 f dash 1 by x plus log y. Okay, so just focus on this equation and this equation. So if I'll divide these two things, okay, this equation and this equation, if I will divide, so what will happen? The right hand side will be what? It will be 1 only, because 2 f dash will get cancelled, correct? No. So this, if I'll write it again, so this is nothing but minus p x square divided by this term. This term is what? Y into q minus 2y, okay, equals 1. Or that is all, right? I can simplify it in right? So minus p x square is nothing but y q. That means you can write down q y minus 2y square, or totally up to you. So this also I can write as my answer. I can write p x square minus, if everywhere if I'll take, so p x square minus, so plus qy equals 2y square. This can also be my answer. And why I'm saying that this is my final answer, I don't have to do anything else, because whatever form I have got here, right now, this part also, I'm not having function present here. So if the function is not there, left hand side, right hand side, all those elements are allowed, p, x, q, y, all those things are allowed. So I can say that this is my required partial differential equation, and which all things are allowed and not allowed, if you have seen the previous videos, the lecture number 1, 2, then you will be understanding much better way, like what I'm talking about. Okay, so this is my answer, I think. So yeah, so this also we have done in the same fashion. So px square plus qy equals 2y square. Okay, the same answer, fine. So now we are going to see the second question. Okay, so second question is z equals e raised to y into function x plus y. Now what my job is, they have said us to form the partial differential equation from this given equation. This equation is not partial differential equation, correct? No, because this contains function, this does not contain any partial derivative of this function and all those things which suits for the definition of partial differential equation. So my job is to convert it into partial differential equation. But the method is, I have to eliminate the function from here. Okay, so the step number 1 is exactly same, if even if I'm using by eliminating the constant or eliminating the function, the step is same, that you have to first find the partial derivative of the given equation. So partial derivative, if you are going to find, so with respect to what you are going to find the partial derivative of given equation, so with respect to all those variables which all are present in your equation. So in my this equation, two variables are present, so I have to find the partial derivative of this function z the partial derivative of this complete equation with respect to x also and with respect to y also. This is the step. Okay, so that means now the left hand side again I'm writing del by del x of z, and right hand side also del by del x of whatever is given to me, I'm just copying it here. Okay, now del by del x of z is p, that we know, and then del by del x of this is what, e raised to x with respect to del by del x is constant, correct? So this I'm just taking outside, treating it as constant. I'm treating y as constant. This is the definition of my partial derivative, fine. So now I'm writing down del by del x of function x plus y, or the same if I'm continuing here only. So this is e raised to y, and then f dash, okay, x plus y. So even if you are writing del by del x of some function, any function, whatever you are going to find the derivative, or del by del y, very first thing is same thing, you just have to write with the dash, f dash x plus y. Now if you are finding the partial derivative with respect to x or with respect to y, that matters what is present inside this function, correct? No. So for this is what, for, so this x will be 1 only, y will be 0. So this is enough, right? Now what I'm going to write here, so this is my equation only, right? So this equation is p equals e raised to y f dash x plus y. So this is the equation which we also have got. Now I'm going to find del by del y of z, right? So del by del y of left hand side equals del by del y of right hand side, e raised to y f x plus y. Okay, so now left hand side will become q, and the right hand side will be what? It will be your product rule, correct? No, I'm using this formula for that. So q equals, this is my e raised to y, and then f dash x plus y, and then it will be 1. So plus v, that means f x plus y, and then del by del y of e raised to y is e raised to y only. So I can write here q equals e raised to y. Okay, e raised to y f dash x plus y, plus, if you will notice here, this is nothing but your z only. How come this is, see here, the, see, z is e raised to y f x plus y, here also e raised to y f x plus y. Okay, so that is done, right? So what I'm going to write here, so now I got, this is my q. Now this was your p. Okay, so So I'm done with my partial derivative. Now I have to understand that how I'm going to eliminate this function, this f dash x plus y from the given equation. So I can see that e raised to y f dash x plus y, which is equal to p. I mean, you can see here, okay? So this is one equation and this is second equation. So in this case, how I will manage to eliminate this f dash x plus y? So this e raised to y f dash x plus y, I can write as p only, correct? Because p is e raised to y f dash x plus y plus z. And now this is only my required partial differential equation, because p, q, z all are allowed, okay? So this is our answer. And you can use any method to simplify, whether you are going to divide these two equations or any method, but the answer will be same, fine? Now we will be seeing the third question. So third question is lx plus my plus nz equals phi x square plus y square plus z square, okay? So in this equation, if it is given to me to form the partial differential equation from this given equation by eliminating the arbitrary function, okay? That means what I have to eliminate and what I need to keep. So if I just have to eliminate the arbitrary function, so I don't worry about my constant or arbitrary constant and all, okay? So this L, X, M, Y, N, Z, X, Y, Z, everything will be allowed. Only what is going to be eliminated is this function, which is represented by phi. And this is function, why? Because you can see this is the notation. So the name could be anything, okay? So I need to eliminate this function phi, okay? So the same method we are applying. And the method is, I'm going to see that how many independent variables are given. So this L, M, N, they are the constant, arbitrary constant. I'm not worrying about arbitrary constant. I don't have to eliminate arbitrary constant. I have to eliminate only arbitrary function. So I will be keeping if M, N, L, whatever will be coming in my answer, I will not have any problem with that. But how many times I'm going to find the partial derivative? Since x is given and y is given and z is the function with respect to x and y, so two independent variables are given. So I'm going to find del by del x of this complete thing, left hand side and right hand side, and then I'm going to find del by del y of this left hand side and del by del y of right hand side. So how I'm going to write here? Del by del x of lx plus del by del x of my plus del by del x of nz equals del by del x of this is phi x square plus y square plus z square. So this first term will give you L only, fine, this L is the arbitrary constant, and then plus this will be zero, correct? Why? Because m, y all I am treating as constant with respect to x, plus n is the constant, del by del x of z is going to give me p, okay? Now this is what? This is phi dash x square plus y square plus z square, and then 2x, okay, 2x, and then it will be 0, and then it will be how much? This will be my 2 into z into del by del x of del by del x of z, so that means p, fine. I think this is correct. So this is same thing we have also got, okay? So this is my equation number 2. So how to find this equation number 3? So the method is same. After that, I'm going to find del by del y, for left hand side also and for right hand side also, fine. So for that, what will be the answer if I'm finding out partial derivative with respect to y? So what I'm going to get here? So it will be what? It is nothing but, I'm just writing y here. So this will be 0. Why? Because Lx all will be constant with respect to y. This is my m. And this is my n, and then q, del by del y of z will be q, fine? And this is how much? Phi dash x square plus y square plus z square, and then this will be my 2y plus 2 into z into q, okay? So we have got this equation also. So if two equations are given and then I just need to eliminate this phi dash, So what I should do, I can divide left hand side, right hand side. So in that case, this 5 dash will be eliminated. Okay, 2, 2 also I can cancel out. Okay, so this much we have got here. After that, what we are doing, we are doing this cross multiplication. So this is x plus zp into m plus nq. Okay, and then l plus np plus, l plus np into y plus zq. Okay, and then if you are going to write in some better fashion, so what for that, what we have done? So we have just multiplying the terms. Okay, so now you just have to see that which all, then just you are simplifying it. So now what they have done, this q form, q and q they have taken as common in one place, and then p and then p they have taken in one place, and then it will be same, right? So xm and then yn. So this way also you can write. Okay, so fine. So now this is the fourth and the last question. If I find del by del x of this equation, so how much I will get? So left hand side is del by del x of z, right hand side is how much? Del by del x of e raised to ax plus by into f ax minus by. So left hand side will give me p, and then right hand side is what? This is again the u into v form. So it is your e raised to ax plus by, and then I am saying this is nothing but f dash ax minus by into a. Okay, no, for a this one. Okay, now plus this is how much? This f will be as it is, f ax minus by, and then finding derivative of e raised to ax plus by into, it will be your a. Okay, similarly we can find del by del y of z. So it will be q, and the same fashion we will be just partially differentiating with respect to y, and then we got other equation, and then I just had to simplify looking at these two equations only. So I can see that this is nothing but e raised to ax plus by f ax plus by. Okay, so f ax minus by, this is nothing but z, so this is a into z. Similarly here also, this is nothing but this, instead of this part I can write down b into z. Okay, and then finally I will just divide these two equations, will eliminate this f dash x minus by, and then we'll get the answer. Okay, yeah, so same thing we have done here also. So what we are writing down, we are multiplying this equation number 2 by b. So if we will multiply this with b, so both things will be same, correct? No, and then if I'm multiplying this third equation with respect to a, so then it will be this much, and then we can cancel out these two things. If I'm adding these two equations, this complete term will get cancelled, fine, and then we'll get this equation. So this could be my answer. So I'm not worrying about a b presence. So this is the partial differential equation, what either you write in this form or you write in this form, things are okay. So in coming classes we will be solving different types of questions under the same topic. Okay, so if you find this class useful, please like and subscribe my channel. Thank you.